A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 18th October, on the front page you have Britain clinches Brexit deal with EU. So British Prime Minister Boris Johnson has secured a Brexit deal with European Union more than 3 years after Britain's voted to leave EU. So Prime Minister Boris Johnson must still win the majority in Parliament to get the agreement approved. So earlier too, we have seen under former British Prime Minister Theresa May, she had got the deal signed, agreed by European Union, with the government and European Union agreed, but then the Parliament has also to approve it, and it was rejected by the Parliament 3 times. So this time Boris Johnson's deal, what are its major provisions? You can see under the deal, the whole of UK will leave the European Union, but Northern Ireland will stay in the EU single market for goods. So Northern Ireland and Ireland will have open borders in a sense. So UK can impose tariffs on goods entering Northern Ireland from third countries as long as they are not at risk of entering the EU single market. UK can impose tariffs also is a provision. For the goods that are at risk of entering single market from third countries via Northern Ireland, EU tariffs will be applied. So where UK can impose tariffs and where EU can impose tariffs has been clarified. And it is said practically there will be a customs border between Great Britain and the island of Ireland. So goods being checked will be checked at Northern Irish ports. So now this has to be approved by the British Parliament. We know that 31st October is the deadline for Brexit. So before that, if a deal comes forth, then great. That's what Boris Johnson had promised, that he would get Brexit completed by October 31. But now it all rests on British Parliament. Then next is Legislative Council abolished in Jammu and Kashmir. So this 70-year-old institution in Jammu and Kashmir comes into an end. You can see the upper house of the assembly. It was abolished as per Section 57 of Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Bill 2019, which has reduced the state of Jammu and Kashmir into two union territories of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. So the Legislative Council has been abolished. You can see the details are given. All staff members of the council shall report to the General Administration Department now, and the Secretary of the Council has been directed to transfer all records to the Department of Law. Also, vehicles purchased for the council have been shifted to state's garages. And then here you have, who is stopping us from amending history, asks Amit Shah. So he talks about Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, and he says he gave us an Indian perspective to 1857 rebellion. The first Indian War of Independence was the book written by Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, highlighting how revolt of 1857 was first Indian War of Independence. So in that context, Union Home Minister Amit Shah says that there's a need to rewrite history from an Indian point of view, and he says, who's stopping us from amending history? Then below you have bikes exempted from odd even scheme. So we had seen the Delhi government, it had to take a decision on whether the odd even scheme would apply to two wheelers or not, but it has come under the list of exempted vehicles. We have seen how the public transport of Delhi will not be able to take the burden. So there is no other alternative. Also, vehicles carrying children in school uniform is exempted. Vehicles driven by women and carrying children up to 12 years is exempted. Emergency vehicles are exempted. On page 9, you have TB cases see decrease in India. So number of patients have fallen by almost 50,000 over the past year, according to World Health Organization report. So India has performed better in countering tuberculosis, according to World Health Organization's 2019 edition of Global Tuberculosis Report. So you can see a comparison between 2017 and 18, and number of cases tested for rifampicin resistance among new patients has actually increased. But number of percentage of cases tested for rifampicin resistance among previously treated patients has reduced. So total TB incidence has also reduced. On the editorial page, you have awaiting the verdict. So this is regarding Ayodhya dispute. It is said mediation is the only way to deal with the faith related arguments. So the Supreme Court hearing has completed, the marathon hearing, and even the mediation committee has submitted its report. So now the verdict would be announced in a month or so. and this is the secondary monsoon. So this talks about how there is little understanding of the behavior of the Indian Ocean and monsoon impact. So how Indian Ocean impacts the monsoon. So now it will be the retreating monsoon, the northeast monsoon rains, which contribute about 20% of India's annual rainfall during October to December. So this is discussed here. So it's in the southern states where these monsoon rains bring about 15%, these monsoon rains are seen, and retreating monsoon rains. So even the El Nino phenomena, how does it affect monsoon in India, is discussed. And the lead article, vital additions to empirical research. So this talks about randomized control trials. So this was the technique established by Nobel Prize winner in economics this year, Abhijit Banerjee, Esther Duflo and Michael Kremer. So this article says that despite limitations, the use of randomized control trials has led to a paradigm shift in development policy evaluation. So this aspect is covered here, randomized control trials, which we have discussed how it was used in education, health, such trials being conducted as such. Then this is the dominant caste dilemma. So this article says that the BJP forces dominant castes to moderate their posture to aggregate weaker sections. The Congress is still learning. Then on Fridays on op-ed page, you have a parlay coverage where an issue is picked up and different views are taken on it. So present question is, what can India do to overcome global slowdown? So we are seeing slowdown in the economy, and it has global contribution too. So it says strengthening the manufacturing industry and increasing domestic demand are the key imperatives. So how do we go about it is detailed out here. And this is greening the powerhouses. So it talks about how climate change is still not integral to the planning of Indian cities and towns, despite the risks it poses. On page 13, you have FATF may keep Pakistan on grey list. So Pakistan is presently in grey list, and a review would take place, and it is expected it is going to continue to be in the grey list. But it says the country is likely to be issued strong warnings and put under pressure. So the final decision of FATF's International Cooperation Review Group on listing Pakistan will be taken today. So blacklisting is unlikely because Pakistan has support from China and Malaysia. So if not downgraded, Pakistan is expected to be kept under significant and sustained pressure to deliver on the action plan by February 2020. So the Asia Pacific group of FATF will give its report. And the report which has been provided is has assigned a national risk rating of medium to the country on countering the two aspects which FATF looks into, that is terror financing and money laundering. So countering terror financing and anti-money laundering are two objectives. So it is said Pakistan has taken positive actions against organizations, terror organizations as such, but it has not fully implemented the requirements under UN Security Council resolution. So it has registered 228 terror finance cases and convicted 58 individuals. But to maintain sustained pressure, it will continue to be under grey list is what is expected. And this is pilgrims to Kartarpur will have to undergo security check. So central government is worried that Pakistan might push propaganda and weapons. So pilgrims visiting the Kartarpur shrine in Pakistan will have to undergo thorough security check upon their return, because of the concerns that India has that Pakistan might push propaganda material, small weapons or narcotics through it. Then on the international page, you have what we saw on the front page regarding Brexit deal, which has been clinched between Britain and European Union, but it has to still be approved by the British Parliament. And below you have Turkey agrees to Syria ceasefire. So a 120-hour pause would be taken, which will let Kurds pull out of the safe zone. So this is under US Vice President Mike Pence, that Turkey has agreed to a ceasefire to allow Kurdish forces as such to safely withdraw from an area in northern Syria. On business page you have, for FMCG, rural growth worst in 7 years. So it is said high rural inflation, lowest annual wage hike since 2009, and floods leading to crop loss are the key factors why rural demand is dampened. And for fast moving consumer goods, it is worst in 7 years. On the last page, you have NASA eyeing inflatable space lodges for moon. So 5 companies are providing inputs, and plan is by NASA is to have astronauts orbit the moon or live on its surface in a decade or so. So they'll be probably doing so inside inflatable space lodges, which are now being developed. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.